Emerson. Bennett. Emerson. Here's Pickering. It's a goal! Nick Pickering. Out of nothing, really. They were looking for the cross. And Pickering discovered a shot that when the cross sagas and into the far corner. It's really in keeping with the balance of the match that Coventry should go in front. It looked as though the defender was jockeying him, Butterworth, well enough. But it went through his attempted block and it sped past Sagers. Thank you. Strachan. Robson's moving into the centre forward position here. This is Gibson. And still. And there. Oh, Whiteside came in and it's dropped in. Ogrizovic couldn't have done much about that. There appeared to be a deflection. Gibson got almost to the line. Norman Whiteside got a touch and it got on the goalkeeper's arm and just trickled in. So Ogrizovic a bit unlucky really. Peake got half a touch on it. Burrows through the crowd, deflection. Gin! Oh, what a good goal! Michael Gin! His fifth in 10 games. The lad who may only be a sub at Wembley, but would dearly love to start the match. And if he produces shots like this, he's a hard man to leave out. It ricocheted off two Manchester players, but when it fell for Gin, he buried that right in the corner.
Just can't quite make himself the space. Downs. Phillips for Hutchin.
Oh, it might fall for the Coventry man. It's in. 20 minutes gone, and Coventry take the lead through Keith Houchin, the man whose penalty for York City defeated Arsenal in the fourth round of the FA Cup two seasons ago. Well, Regis battling for space on that far side. It was Downs who finally knocked the ball in, then it fell to Phillips, and finally to Houchin, and with Turner on the floor, Coventry finally forced it into the roof of the net. And now, what can Manchester United do?
Stoke in round five had Coventry laughing with a Mickey Jean special. And suddenly there was belief.
Regis, Bennett steps over the attentions of Madden. Regis, now Cyril Regis with just Hodge to beat, and he has! Cyril Regis, his 12th goal of the season, and Coventry have done what they've threatened already in this match, and that's breaking from the halfway line with pace. A neat little link-up between Regis and Bennett, who stepped over the attentions of Madden, the ball into the path of Regis, who was able to run forward with a clear sight of goal and beat Hodge. Hodge, again, a long way out of his goal. Flicked on. Shelton hunting and Metzen! And Coventry's concentration has finally lapsed, and Metzen has put Wednesday back into this match. Thumbs up from Gary Metzen, his sixth goal of the season. The man whose father captained Wednesday in the FA Cup final of 1966 when they lost to Everton 3-2. And Coventry get possession. Bennett. Regis lets it run under his feet to Houchin. Houchin, has he made himself space? Oh, he came off the defender! It's an own goal! Houchin will take the credit. Hodge looks in dismay, but it's Smith. Well, the question will always remain, would Hodge have saved it? But the shot from Houchin took a deflection off Mark Smith and flew past Martin Hodge, and Coventry are back in front. Dismay for Mark Smith after 78 minutes of this quarter-final. A deflected own goal, and Coventry back in front 2-1. Well, Keith Houchin knows all about winning cup ties, doesn't he? The penalty that beat Arsenal when he played for York in the fourth round two seasons ago. The goal that beat Manchester United in the fourth round in this year's competition. Worthington, oh, it's fallen in the path of Houchin! It's number three! It's all over now! Salutes the Coventry supporters. A lucky break. Desperate situation for Wednesday, but that has wrapped it up now. Houchin, a gift of a goal. His second of the match. It's Coventry 3, Wednesday 1. And for the Coventry fans, believe me, are not only celebrating what looks like a great victory here, they're also celebrating a new Coventry City side.
Breakthrough. And Coventry's marking was say, on every corner they've taken, Leeds at the moment, they've had spare...
They haven't spent any time with Coventry and their supporters. I'm getting the feeling they thought that this would be their year. And if it's going to be, they're going to go on to Wembley. Something dramatic has got to happen, and maybe David Bennett has done it here. McGrath missed it, Mickey Ginn has it.
What must Brendan Ormsby have been thinking about there? He could have played the ball anywhere. Full marks to Benny for persistence, but look at this now. Centre-half who hasn't put a foot wrong this half.
McGrath couldn't make contact, but Ginn found the corner. And Mervyn Day, you saw, look away there, furious with Brendan Ormsby. Because there's no way that he could allow David Bennett to do that. And Ginn, the substitute, has altered the... Bennett got the better of Adams again. And they're wearing Leeds down on this side of the field. And Bennett, beautifully done. Houchin! And it was Adams who rescued it, because Houchin had a shot that seemed to be going towards an unguarded part of the net until Leeds' bodies were thrown into the line of it. Ginn is there, Houchin this time, and he's round there, and he's scored, and Coventry set here into the lead, and Keith Houchin, who is the FA Cup specialist, is the player responsible. To beat the goalkeeper, and Adams could do nothing about it. A player who scored only once in the First Division all season has now got four in the FA Cup run. Ashurst. Ready. Now Ritchie. And he's beaten two, Andy Ritchie. On the edge of the area, they've got Kilcline, Regis and Houchin. Phillips just outside the area, and it's Mickey Ginn to take the free kick. Regis, Houchin and Bennett! Coventry regain the lead. A simple tap in for David Bennett.
Big Regis does well here to keep the ball in play, gets a ball off his head and pulls it to the danger zone. Four marks to Houchin, he shows a sort of poacher's sense of being...
in there, Houchin was marking him. Clive Allen's play answered the referee. Allen seemed to use his back. It's come out again to Chris Waddle. It's his back. Allen! Clive Allen! Would you believe it? In the second minute, goal number 49 for the footballer. Ogrizovic in climbing. Kilcline is there. Got clearance only as far as Gin. Regis, Houchin waiting in the centre. Phillips. Kilcline. Regis, Downs. Houchin. John Sillett, they're level after 9 minutes. Greg Downs curled the ball in. Houchin with the flick on, a lovely header. Clements went down, but Bennett was quicker and scored. It'll be Hoddle to take it. And Goff's there.
Pickering, Michael Gin, David Phillips.
Phillips who switched positions. Keith Houchin, the man who seems almost married to the FA Cup. And David Bennett, who had a hand in two of the goals.